everybody out there on YouTube, and welcome to race number 5 of Season 9 NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series. I'm Levi McIntyre, a.k.a. ThrashManiac99, the voice of NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series, here to welcome you to the Bojangles 400 here at Tennessee Superspeedway, where we're getting set to go 30 laps of racing here at this brand new restrictor play racetrack that, if this race turns out successful, this might be a future staple to the Walmart Cup Series schedule. But with that said, before we look at points in the starting lineup, if you skipped over the intro, the 12 drivers that made it in for this race via knockout qualifying were Mason Powers, William Brock, Chris Washer, Katie Cochran, Caleb Farrell, Zach Rogers, John Cittadino, Ryan Acosta, Chase Oliver, William Duncan, Kyle Keith, and Matthew Dalio. And also, this race is the final race for drivers who are on the outside looking into the top 30 currently to try and make it in and get locked in for races. And this is the last race for the people from last season that were in the top 30 in points, or got the charters for being outside, but because drivers from last season are not here, they took their spots. So this is the last race for those guys to try to keep improving and hope to stay in it for races to come. But with that said, let's take a look at the point standings. DJ Curtis still leads the points by 21 points over Johnny Gardner. Third is Dylan Young. Fourth, Kyle Matthews. Fifth, Tim Walsh. Sixth, and also our pole setter for tonight, is Pichu London. Seventh, Trent Dunham. Eighth, Katie Cochran, the highest of the rookies and the go-or-go-homer, so she is virtually going to be locked in from now on for races. Ninth, Jesse Setti. Tenth, Preston Plord. Rest of the top 20 is Charles Sanford, Joshua Collard, James McLeod, Sean Galligan, Anthony McCrory, Angel Navarro, Bob Jones, David Rivera, Seth Cole, and Chris Washer. So there you go. Top 10 in the starting lineup. Pichu London on the pole with Preston Plord in second. Row 2 is Matt McIntyre and Kyle Matthews. Row 3 is John Cittadino and Trent Dunham. Row 4, Jessica Sheldon and Kyle Keith. And then row 5, Jesse Setti and Joshua Collard. Starting in the last row is Mason Powers and Johnny Gardner. With that said, let's go ahead and get the command to fire engines for the Bojangles 400 at Tennessee Superspeedway, second race of the Tennessee Trifecta.
Is this on? Drivers, start your engines.
Awkward again. But yeah, this is a track I've only seen been used in other series once, and it was from a recent NNSCRA Hershey's Cup Series event where Seth Cole ran this track, and it looked really interesting, so I decided, you know what, let's give this track a go for this series and see how it goes. However, I do notice it is pretty low framey. Now it's gaining frames. It's like it looks like in certain sections the frames are pretty bad. But yeah, from the looks of the layout of the racetrack, it's pretty wide, and you could possibly make 5 wide even work if you really want to try and risk it. 4 wide you can definitely make it work, and then 3 and 2 and 3 wide for sure. 4 wide you could probably make it work really well. 5 wide you can, as long as you don't lead or lean. And then 6 wide could be a no-no. It depends on what we're going to be seeing throughout the course of this race, as the pace car pulling into what will be looking like to be an invisible pit road. But anyways, we're getting ready to get to racing here at Tennessee Superspeedway in the Smoky Mountains, which is a second home for me. And boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys and girls. Get guess there is no invisible pit road. There is a pit road. I just thought it was somewhere random, but there you go. Already cars going 3-4 wide. Looking to get some stuff going. As Pichu London, who had a good run going last week at Bristol, but due to pit strategy, it cost him a top 5 finish. He ended up finishing around 17th, I want to say, is where he finished. So he has an opportunity for redemption here this week. But now he's about to get bypassed by John Cittadino, a go-or-go-home driver out of the Sevens Racing in the number 72 Chevy. And already I saw a bit of 5 wide right there. And that was the end of lap number 1. And John Cittadino led that lap. And now here comes Chris Washer, Zach Rogers, Sean Galligan all in the mix. As two fellow Dodge Darts working together on the bottom. Joshua Collar trying to give help to Dodge Dart affiliate Zach Rogers, just for different teams. Rogers for Bulldog Motorsports. Collar for Richard Petty Motorsports. And now here comes Rogers down low for the top spot underneath of Cittadino. Man, this racing's getting pretty hectic. 4 wide everywhere. And they're getting close to 200 miles an hour. I saw one of them get around 199. Now they're picking up speed. And now here comes Charles Sanford, who led that lap. It was Rogers. Look at the beautiful shot from the spectator camera right here. Johnny Gardner, looks like Johnny Gardner lost the draft. Dylan Poteet slowly losing the draft as well. Wow, look at that. They are 5 wide right there. And whoa, there they go! Mongold is around. And whoa, a couple cars going for wild rides. Kind of figured that was going to happen once I saw them lean in the 5 wide battle. Couldn't tell who led the lap that time. Looked like it was McLeod, but by like a photo finish margin over Charles Sanford right there, as a multi-car accident has occurred here at Tennessee Superspeedway. James McLeod, your race leader, let's quickly go ahead and take a look at the replay of what brought the caution out for the first time today here at Tennessee. Well, super slow motion right here to get the timing of this ride. Yeah, they were leaning in the middle of a 5-wide battle, and right there, it's like Pichu London was the meat in the sandwich between his teammate Dylan Thoreau and Preston Plourd, and right as they slide up, it spins Austin Mongold out, and that collects London and Zach Rogers, who was a leader, and then right there, the hit from Preston Plourd into Kyle Matthews gets them both up on 2 wheels. Right there. So Kyle Matthews was an innocent bystander in that incident. Let's look at it again via the helicopter angle where we did see the wreck occur. Yeah, right there, Thoreau comes up into London and into Plourd and Mongold, and that turns him around. And then Matthews, let me look and see this shot from Matthews. Yeah, Matthews got forced up into the wall from that hit from Preston Plourd and looked like they were going to save him. Then right there, Plourd gets hit by Pichu and then slides up and slams into Kyle Matthews. See to make sure if Johnny Gardner is going to get through, and it looks like he will. So great job for these guys who managed to not get involved in that accident scene. But let's go ahead and take you to the restart here at Tennessee. Well, surprisingly enough, no cars retired out of the race after that crash. So everybody who's started the race still on track. However, the leaderboard has changed because everybody came in the pit road, but Katie Cochran is your leader, second is David Rivera, third is Jessica Sheldon, fourth James McLeod, fifth Angel Navarro, sixth is Charles Sanford, seventh is P.J. Williams, eighth Dylan Thoreau, ninth William Duncan, tenth Jesse Setti. Excuse me. Anyways, 11th is Sean Galligan, 12th is Mason Powers, 13th Ryan Acosta, 14th Austin LaPlante, 15th Trent Dunham, 16th Joshua Collard, 17th is William Brock, 18th DJ Curtis, 19th John Cittadino, 20th Dougie Shears, 21st is Bob Jones with a new Pizza Hut paint scheme, 22nd Chris Washer, 23rd Chase Oliver, 24th Dylan Young, 25th Michael Norman, 26th is Kyle Keith, 27th Caleb Farrell, 28th Matthew Dalio, 29th Dorian Facepuncher, 30th Seth Cole, 31st Anthony McCrory, 32nd Tanner Sullivan, 33rd Dylan Poteet, 34th Johnny Gardner, 35th Tim Walsh, 36th Matt McIntyre, 37th Carson Gumm, 38th Zach Rogers, 39th Austin Mongold, 40th Kyle Matthews, 41st Preston Plord, and then 42nd is Pichu London. Katie Cochran, who so far this season in them knockout qualifying sessions has made every race this season, so she's in good hands to be locked in for the remaining races of the season if she continues to stay in the top 30, that is. And she does come into this race 8th in points. So far for her first ever season here in this series, she's been doing pretty well for herself. Nearly won the Daytona 500, finishing 2nd to DJ Curtis. And we're back at plate track, so she might be able to pull one off here today. As we're getting set for the restart with 23 laps to go. And there we go. Jessica Sheldon, among others, going below David Rivera to get on by. James McLeod, Angel Navarro, and Charles Sanford follow suit. Now they're going to separate it a little bit. As Sheldon up to second, as it's a double female up front, with Katie Cochran leading and Jessica Sheldon in second. Jesse Setti, the third female in this race, in the top 10. The only female in the series that's not here in this race is Stephanie Naylor, Johnny Gardner's fiance. But the women representing the series proudly by doing very well so far here this race. And Katie Cochran leads that lap. Sheldon's still right behind. And now here comes PJ Williams, who's definitely looking to get a good finish after he got wrecked out last week at Bristol in the first of the three races for the Tennessee Trifecta. Because next week, we head to Nashville Superspeedway, the short track, and that should be quite interesting. And now here comes Williams now to the lead, but now James McLeod is going to try to make a move, as here comes Jesse Setti underneath of her teammate Katie Cochran. As Setti's given the shot to McLeod, and now here she comes down low. William Brock trying to make something work as well. Ryan Acosta, I see, in the 10 car, working his way up gradually through the field. Michael Norman, same way, and I see Trent Dunham, Mason Powers, Austin LaPlante, All getting there. Whoa, some contact right there. William Brock Jesse Setti. That could have been bad if they kept leaning like that. That could have been a big problem. Four wide up here at the front. And now we got a new leaders. Angel Navarro gets to lead, but he might get freight trained here in a moment because McLeod has got the draft help from PJ Williams. I don't know. Let's see who gets across the line first. It was Navarro, but now McLeod clears the 19 for the lead as we're a third of the way through this race. 20 laps to go. Michael Norman getting help from Trent Dunham. After all, Richard Childress Racing and Sega Motorsports are pretty much close to each other. As Norman now up to the front, Katie Cochran coming back up there. William Duncan in the 66 making, I think it's his second or third start this season, and he's up here trying to battle for the lead or just to get a good finish right now. Meanwhile, more craziness, four wide, five wide even back there. Oh, contact, Kyle Keefe, Jessica Shelton. Whoa, Kyle! That could have been bad. And as you can see back here, Tanner Sullivan, Carson Gumm, Johnny Gardner have lost the draft again. And then you got the five slower machines of Mongold, London, Plord, Rogers, and then there's Kyle Matthews, all running separately throughout the field. As Katie Cochran led that lap, as she retakes the top spot, PJ Williams back up here, and now I see Dougie Shears in the 83 trying to work his way up there. A little pack of cars that is separated from the main pack. Six car pack right here led by Mason Powers. With Chase Oliver, Dylan Thoreau, Seth Cole, John Cittadino, Mac McIntyre all here. As everybody else from the main pack still running up here. Well, and it looks like pit stops are happening. Oh, and Katie Cochran gets spun! And Woco, my goodness. I don't think a caution is out. Whoa, and Jesse Setti, Dylan Thoreau about had problems. Trying to figure out whether or not NNSCRA decided to bring the caution out for that accident. Yeah, the caution is out. And man, right is when cars were getting on the pit road for pit strategy purposes. But Angel Navarro is your current leader at the moment. But let's quickly go ahead and take a look at a replay of what brought the caution out for the second time today here at Tennessee Superspeedway. Right at the moment of cars trying to get on the pit road, and there you see Katie's going down to get on. Pulls down right in front of William Brock, and that's going to send Brock sideways. And Katie goes around and actually slides up a little bit and scrapes the four of William Brock. And then up here, Jesse Setti about got into it a little bit with someone. Actually, no, that was, as I just messed that up big time. Let's see if I can go back a ways. Because I thought I saw her get pretty sideways. Yeah, that was right there as she was pulling up. and didn't see Dylan Thoreau right there, and they made contact, and they didn't crash, surprisingly enough. But yeah, that spin out with the 12 and the 4 was what brought the caution out, but let's go ahead and take you to the restart at Tennessee. Well, it looks like potentially an accident occurred on pit road, and that's why Pichu London and David Rivera are all of a sudden out of the race. Too bad we won't be able to check the replay of it because of the live feed and trying to skip to the restarts every time. So two cars are out, but anyways, many pit stops took place under that caution, and Michael Norman is your leader, second is Jessica Shelton, third is Carson Gumm, fourth is James McLeod, fifth Jesse Setti, sixth is Angel Navarro, seventh Dougie Shears, eighth William Duncan, ninth William Brock, tenth is Austin LaPlante, 11th is Caleb Farrell, 12th is Trent Dunham, 13th is Dylan Poteet, 14th Joshua Collard, 15th is Dorian Facepuncher, 16th Sean Galligan, who looks to have a buckle on his hood, 17th Chris Washer, 18th Matthew Dalio, 19th Charles Sanford, 20th Katie Cochran, who looks like got more damage. Maybe there was a stack-up on pit road, and that's why there's a lot of cars with buckles on their hoods or rear-end damage. Anyways, 21st, Kyle Keefe, 22nd is John Cittadino, 23rd is Tim Walsh, 24th, Seth Cole, 25th, Mason Powers, 26th is Johnny Gardner, 27th, Dylan Thoreau, 28th, Matt McIntyre, 29th is Zach Rogers, 30th, Austin Mongold, 31st, Preston Blord, 32nd, Kyle Matthews, 33rd, P.J. Williams, 34th, Ryan Acosta, 35th, Anthony McCrory, 36th is Tanner Sullivan, 37th, D.J. Curtis, 38th, Bob Jones, 39th, Dylan Young, 40th is Chase Oliver. We're about to go back to racing with 13 laps to go here at Tennessee, and I do feel like there will be one more pit stop left before this race is over. Pace car in the pit road. Michael Norman leads us down to the line. And green flag is back out. Norman didn't get off to quite as good of a restart as Jessica Shelton did, because Shelton is now right on the back bumper of the three, and now here she comes down low for the top spot. Angel Navarro about to get draft help from fellow Toyota Dougie Shears underneath Carson Gumm. Yeah, I've got a feeling the field's going to get separated quite a lot as a result of a few cars having buckles on their hoods and perhaps going to be slowing off the pace after what I would assume what happened as to why Pichu London and David Rivera are out is because of a big stack-up that happened on one of the groups of pit stops. And the caution's back out, and Katie Cochran, James McLeod are on pit road, Jesse Setti around, William Brock in the back now. So it looked like we had a multi-car accident once again. As Dougie Shears is leading. Whoa, why is Jesse Setti sitting on track? What in the world is going on here? I'm guessing maybe there were some cars that ran out of fuel because they were cars who couldn't get on the pit road because of that last caution. I think that's what happened. There were cars who ran out of fuel because they couldn't pit. I'm thinking that's what happened. Maybe one of these cars ran out of gas and it caused a problem. That is a bizarre thing to have had to have happen. Yeah, I'm thinking that is what happened. Cars just ran out of gas and just couldn't get going. But Dougie Shears is your leader. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what really happened to bring the caution out for the third time today here at Tennessee. So it looks like the incident's going to begin with Jesse Setti, because we're coming to the restart. Setti restarted fourth, and I was wondering where she went and why the field got separated. Right there she pulls off because she ran out of gas. Yeah, she definitely ran out of gas because she's only going 57 miles an hour. Now we got to figure out what happened to start a crash. Could it have been from Setti coming back up the racetrack, perhaps? I don't know. She's by herself at that moment. Let's go up here. Well, actually, let me go to McLeod. Oh, there he is. Yeah, he ran out of gas, too. It was way before what happened to Jesse Setti. This happened way before that. And I think the same thing is going to happen with Katie Cochran. Let me find... Yeah, there she is. I think the same thing's going to happen to her, so that's why the caution was out. A few cars who couldn't get on the pit road because of either getting spun in that last caution or just got blocked out and couldn't get in, and they ran out of gas and were stopped on the racetrack. Yeah, there you see the 12 pulling down. So yeah, just three cars just got screwed over by the last caution, couldn't pit, and ran out of gas. So at least it wasn't a crash, it was just a case of just cars running out of fuel. But let's go ahead and take you back to the restart here at Tennessee. Well, no cars retired out of the race. However, Jesse Setti is two laps down, and Katie Cochran, James McLeod are on the tail end of the field as a result of the pit stops and the caution. So when we get back racing, it will be eight laps to go. Dougie Shears is your leader. Second is Caleb Farrell. Third is Angel Navarro. Fourth, Austin LaPlante. Fifth, Dylan Poteet. Sixth is William Duncan. Seventh is Carson Gum. Eighth, Michael Norman. Ninth, Jessica Sheldon. Tenth, Kyle Keefe. 11th is Chris Washer. 12th is Tim Walsh. 13th, Dylan Thoreau. 14th, Matthew Dalio. 15th, Matt McIntyre. 16th, Mason Powers. 17th, Charles Sanford. 18th is, 18th, Trent Dunham. 19th, Seth Cole. 20th, Johnny Gardner. 21st, Ryan Acosta. 22nd, Bob Jones. 23rd, Dylan Young. 24th, John Cittadino. 25th, Dorian Facepuncher. 26th, Chase Oliver. 27th, Tanner Sullivan. 28th, William Brock. 29th, P.J. Williams. 30th, D.J. Curtis. 31st is Joshua Collar. 32nd, Austin Mungle. 33rd, Sean Galligan. 34th, Kyle Matthews. 35th, Preston Plourd. 36th, Zach Rogers. 37th is Anthony McCrory. And then 38th, Katie Cochran. 39th, James McLeod. 40th, Jesse Setti. So this is going to be an interesting restart, considering you got two cars in front of Shears, one of them off the pace being the 12 car, and then McLeod is on the tail end. As we get set for the final eight laps of this race. I'm confident I think we can finish under green. I as now the up-to-speed cars are now going to go by the 12 of Katie Cochran, McLeod being the first one to do that. Battle for the lead as here comes Caleb Farrell with a run on the inside of Dougie Shears, who's now going to get held up by the 12. So that's going to help the 91, who's a go-or-go-home driver, attempt to get his first win already in his career in this series. William Duncan now trying to work his way up to the front. Same with Austin LaPlante. It's going to be a drag race to the line, but Farrell led that lap as it's now 7 laps to go here at Tennessee. So we get this cool shot from the spectator camera. As William Duncan has the lead, and now here comes Austin LaPlante with a run with the help of Kyle Keith. And now Kyle Keith, Jessica Sheldon leave LaPlante hanging as they're going to try to work their way up to the front. Dylan Thoreau, Tim Walsh are on the bottom as well. And now here comes Thoreau in the 26, trying to work his way up to the front too. Now Tim Walsh breaks out. Tim Walsh in the 15 trying to get up there as Kyle Keith in the 42 is the leader. Tim Walsh in the 15, still right behind the 42, and now Carson Gumm working his way up there, Michael Norman. And a guy we haven't really talked about all race long is now all of a sudden up here, Matthew Dalio in the 25, the rookie out of Tweenix Racing. Matt McIntyre, who I saw earlier on, lost a draft, and now he's now battling to get in the top 10, and is in the top 10 right now. Battle for lead is now Tim Walsh is going to go underneath and go by Kyle Keefe for the top spot. As when we get to the line, it's going to be 5 laps to go here at the Smoky Mountains here in Tennessee Superspeedway. And it'd be the end of the second of the triple Tennessee trifecta. As next week we head to the short track of Nashville Superspeedway, which is going to be interesting in and of itself. And earlier I was talking about Matthew Dalio all of a sudden coming up, and now here he comes for the lead. But Jessica Sheldon pulls down to make it 3 wide for the top spot, but she's got no drafting partner. So don't look like she'll be able to make it work unless Poteet were to get closer to her to give her that little extra speed in the draft. But it's just not working right now, as it's still 3 wide. But Tim Walsh is still going to lead them at the line right there, as Kyle Keith trying to make the high line work. But right now, Matthew Dalio now down low pulls in front of Jessica Sheldon to try to get the inside line to kick in once more, as it's now less than 4 laps to go here in at the Super Speedway of Tennessee Smoky Mountains for the Bojangles 400. Dalio with a good solid car up there, and I think they were 5 wide for a moment. Now they are 5 wide. Oh man, don't lean. Gotta keep our eyes open on this. Now it looks like it's settled out to 4 wide. However, Farrell and LaPlante are not separating from each other. Definitely trying to keep my eye open on this mess. Now it's settled out. Back with the front with less than 3 to go. It's still Matthew Dalio with Jessica Sheldon right on his tail. And now here comes Sheldon with the run down low. Tanner Sullivan, who we saw earlier lose the draft, now is up here in the top three. Most of the Joe Gibbs cars who are in the field are starting to make their presence felt. Angel Navarro getting up there. Same with DJ Curtis. Sheldon led to the line as it's two laps to go now. If a caution were to come out now, the race would in fact be over. So the next flag ends at the white or the caution. As look at them Joe Gibbs cars of Curtis, Sullivan, and Navarro trying to get there. And look at Ryan Acosta in the 10 working his way up here to the front now. As it's nearly 5 wide up here at the front. Like I said, you can make 5 wide work as long as you don't lean. Oh, wait a minute! What in the world? Chase Oliver, I think he's coming in the pit road. I think that's a sign that some of these cars may not have enough gas. White flag displayed, and it's PJ Williams now to the lead all of a sudden. Dorian Facepuncher came off pit road. Oh man, is this race going to turn out to be like what happened at Armory Digital last season in the finale? Cars running out of gas left and right, and who knows what could happen. Not very many cars left up here in this main pack, as they're closing in on slower cars who came out of pit road, Dougie Shears and Bob Jones, as here comes Trent Dunham with a run to the bottom for the lead. DJ Curtis now. Oh, he ran out of gas, or he's coming in the pit road. I think it's pretty much a safe bet for Trent Dunham. Oh, wait, Tim Walsh with a run, but Trent Dunham. Or wait a minute. It was a photo finish. Oh, my goodness. PJ Williams out of nowhere on the outside gets the victory barely over Trent Dunham. PJ Williams gets his first win of the season, and he gets it at Tennessee Superspeedway in what was a close call of a finish. Holy cow. I thought Dunham had it, but I didn't think Williams got a run on the outside until right they got to the line. Holy cow. That could have been maybe, depending on the margin, that could be the closest finish we have ever had in the history of this series, as they are now wrecking. Oh my goodness. But congratulations to PJ Williams. Trent Dunham, so close. He thought he had it, but he did not know that 27 was coming. He comes away with a great run in second. Tim Walsh, solid run in third. Kyle Keith comes away with a great run in fourth, the highest of the go or go home cars. And then Matt McIntyre, solid finish in the fifth spot. Tanner Sullivan, great run in sixth. Matthew Dalio, solid seventh. Charles Sanford with a great run in eighth. Jessica Sheldon, solid ninth place run. And then Angel Navarro rounding out the top 10. Rest of the top 20, Austin LaPlante, Ryan Acosta, Dylan Poteet, Caleb Farrell, Johnny Gardner, Chris Washer, John Cittadino, Seth Cole, Carson Gumm, William Duncan. Then the rest of the cars that finished in the top 30, Michael Norman, Dylan Thoreau, Joshua Collard, DJ Curtis, Sean Galligan, Chase Oliver, Dylan Young, Mason Powers, William Brock, Bob Jones. Then the rest of the cars finished a lap or more down or was out of the race, and they were Dougie Shears, Dorian Facepuncher, Anthony McCrory, Preston Plourd, Kyle Matthews, Austin Mongold, Zach Rogers, James McLeod, Jesse Seddy, Katie Cochran, and then the two cars out of the race, Pichu London and David Rivera. Well, that does it for our coverage here today here at Tennessee Superspeedway, and now, starting with Nashville next week, it's all about who's outside the top 30 now in the points I got to worry about making their way into the races. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. as here are your results, rookie points and regular points heading into Nashville. And this is Levi McIntyre, signing off.